Hi, Alex here from redeveloper.com and welcome back to day 5 of our Christmas calendar tutorial series. And in this one, I will show you how you can create custom Xcode project templates. So let's dive in. Great. If you already haven't done so, go ahead and click down the link below and download the resources for this video. And you will see a folder called template and a template paths. We are going to get to them in just a second, but let me show you what we are going to build out today. So if you open up Xcode, you will see that we can create a new project. Pretty interesting, eh? So, if I click on that, choose a template for your new project sheet just slides down, and you can select from these templates, a single view application, game, augmented reality, and so on. And if you scroll down, you will see that I have already created a redeveloper section with a single view app. And as you can see there, I have my awesome redeveloper logo there. So, what does this single view app do? Well, it constructs a template Xcode project without the main DOT storyboard. You know, I don't really like using storyboards, so I would easily get rid of them from start. But I always had to go ahead and delete the main DOT storyboard. But now, with this template, I can get rid of it right away. So let me show you what I would typically do when I start a single view application from this application group. So I would just select this, click on next, and type in, let's see. Let's click on next, select our folder where we can put it. Yes, let's add it here. Let's create a new folder. I have already tested it here. So new, let's create it. It doesn't really matter. I won't even create a Git repository on my Mac on and or GitHub because this is just for testing purposes. Okay, so that is it. Here we are inside our project. And what I typically do is delete the main.storyboard. So I right click on that and select delete and I move it to trash. Then I remove the reference from the main interface field and then go up to the app delegate. Let me just change this so you may see a little bit bigger fonts. Look better for the screen. So in the application did finish launching options in the app delegate file, I usually go like so, window equals UI window, and we could use the UI bounds here, but anyway, we set the window, make key end visible, and then we have a view controller. Well, basically, I don't like to use the view controller. I always use something like root view controller or main tab bar view controller, something like that. But for now, let us just set the Windows root view controller to be our view controller. And that is it. Now we can run our project, but this is kind of unnecessary extra work. So what we are going to do is create this with the other template file. So let me close this off and let's create a new project file, new and project. And I will select our single view app now. So let's click on next. I will name this, let's say, template. It doesn't really matter. And I can give the root view controller class a name. This is what I add to the root view controller of our window. Root view controller is fine by me. I also have the option to embed this in a navigation controller. I will use this one too because you already know the code without this as I've typed it out. So let's click on the next here and let's add it in the new one. Okay, so let's create that. And now, as you can see, the main interface reference for the main.storyboard is missing, and the main.storyboard is missing also. We now have a root view controller. There we go. And it is basically a UI view controller with a view did load function. And in the app delegate, we have our root view controller instantiated, added our navigation controller with a root view controller, and then added this navigation controller to our Windows root view controller. Of course, we made our window key and visible. So that is it. This is what we are going to do today to create this template. And of course, I will explain everything so you can tweak this template or create your own templates to your liking. So let's close this off and take a look at the text edit file here. So we have two paths. The first one is the default templates, and that is in the applications folder for our Xcode app. If you want to go through it, then you need to open the Xcode app, go to contents. But here I have the path, so I will just open up a new Finder window and just simply select go and go to folder and paste that path in and click on go, of course. And there we go. As you can see, we are inside our Xcode app contents and so on. So go ahead and take a look at that. Now here we have an option, and that is iOS. And here we have our Xcode templates with XC template. And what we, used as a template is a single view app Xcode template. And as you can see here, we have our main.storyboard, two template icons, and the template info.plist file. Now we are going to take a look at that in detail. So if you want, go ahead and take a look at the game Xcode template and so on. Now, what we are going to do is not save our custom template here, because maybe you will install or reinstall Xcode again, and then all of this data will be lost. But we are going to add it to library developer Xcode templates. So let us just go there. So let's open up another Finder window here and select go and go to folder, paste that path in, and let's go there. Okay, so let me just select templates. Here we go. So under project templates, I already have added a developer and so on. So let me just go ahead and let's minimize this and take a look at what we got when you download it. So here we have our templates, project templates, developer, single view app, and here I have the template info and our template icons, the Retina one and the non-Retina one. So the same is pasted in our templates folder under the developer slash Xcode. Okay, so let me just open this up. Simply double tap on it and Xcode will open it as a plist file. Now, let me show you what I have changed and what you can tweak to your liking if you want to create a new Xcode template. So first of all, change the bundle identifier. I just added here developer instead of Apple. Okay, ancestors, you can leave that as that because it inherits from other templates. Great. Concrete, make sure you set it to yes. If you set this to no, then it will not appear on the list, even if it's copy and pasted at the path that you need to add that. So make sure this is set to yes. Description, a description for the template. and sort order, because you might want to add more than one template into a group. Go ahead and select your sort order. This is the first, so I will leave it at one. Now, under options, I want to go into definitions in the template, Xcode template. Here is where the main.storyboard is added, the reference to it, and so on, but we won't use that now. So let's go into item one, and as you can see here, we have the definition, so-called definition, of our root view controller. As you remember, when we started a new project with this template, we had the option to add our root view controller, and we had the option to rename it. This is the default name, and the identifier, and this is important, is root class name. Go ahead, if you are adding more than one classes, go ahead and change this, of course, if this is required, set it to yes, and these identifiers will be used later down the line, so you will see that in just a moment. And the root view controller class, that is just the text that is displayed, and class name of the root view controller, that is the description. Now let's just go even more down, and here we have our language choice, and of course it's Objective-C and Swift. You don't have to have Objective-C if you don't want to. I have just added for the sake of example, and because the default Apple template already has this, so I have tweaked that too. So here we have our nodes, and here we have some items in there, and as you can see, we have a variable root class name, and we add in some comments, import Coco, implementation, file base name, that is this one, if you have not chosen other, or if you have added another one, then it will be added here. Our parent class is UI view controller, and so on. Here we have our implementation methods in the view did load, in the view did load super, and so on. So go ahead, you can tweak your custom class right over here. Okay, let's just scroll down and take a look at item two. Now here we have our navigation controller, and embed in navigation controller is the name. It is a checkbox type, and the default is set to false. And let's take a look at the units, because now we need to have other implementations than this one. So if it is false, then we are simply going to use required options, language choice, Objective-C, and here we have our appdelegate.m. Let me just make this, and unfortunately I cannot make this larger, but hopefully you can see here that we are in the appdelegate.m implementation methods application did finish launching with options body. So we are adding some code in there, and you can only see one line of code, but if you enter it, you can just go down and you will see all of the lines. Okay, go ahead and type out your lines and paste them in there. Or if you rather want to add this via source code, then it is much easier. Just right click on, let me just show you how to do that. Okay, just right click on the info plist file and open with maybe Atom, or open it as a source code inside Xcode. Okay, now let me just go back and take a look at the Swift version. Okay, item one is the Swift version. Let me just go there. Language choice is Swift. And in there, the application did finish launching with options body. We still have the same code, but now with the Swift version. Go ahead and take a look at it now. Window equals UI window, frame UI screen main bounds. Root view controller is the variable root class name. Again, it is fetching this from here. That is the identifier, root class name. okay, and make it visible. Now, this is set to false, and if the check mark for navigation controller or embedding navigation controller is set to true, then we need to add another code, and let me just show you that is it is in Swift, and let's go to definitions, and here we have our code. So let me just scroll down. Here we go. We make our window, UI window, root view controller is the root view controller class, navigation controller, UI navigation controller, root view controller, and we add that root view controller, window, root view controller equals navigation controller, and of course we make our window key and visible. Now that is it. All you have to do is tweak your template info plist file. Okay, I will close on that, and of course you want to add your icons. Now finally, let's talk about these names, the folder names. Here we have a redeveloper, and that is the group name that we you will be shown. And here for the Xcode template, folder name is the name of the Xcode template. So again, let me just show you. If I create a new project, just scroll down. Here it is, redeveloper and single view app. Now, that is it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I dare you to hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and tweak these template files to your liking. And if you did, go ahead and comment down below what you actually changed or did with these template files. I am interested in knowing. Okay, that is it for me today, and I will see you in the next one.